Guys, first of all, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
That was a lot of fun, and it's interesting because you leave the theater, and of course you say this is one of the best animated movies of the year.
Of course you do.
But at the same time, you feel like I watch an adventure movie. I watch a really funny comedy. So I was really satisfied. I was expecting even this movie to be nominated as a best comedy of the year. How important was for you to have the comedic power in this film?
It's super important in that, you know, we try and make we feel like that's kind of a staple of a Disney film. You know, that's part of the broad entertainment. It's got to be funny. It's got to have great characters, a great world. But to be honest, the most important thing to us was the emotion. That's what we worked the hardest on, to make sure that we were really honoring the story of Hero's story, you know, the story about loss. And so everything had to work together. The comedy had to work in the same film as the drama, and that was a tricky thing, trying to get all that to play well together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think there's an expectation, knowing that there's sort of Marvel DNA and there's a Disney feature animated film, that you're going to have great comedic moments and really fantastic action set pieces. We felt that that's something we need to deliver on. But yeah, we needed to, more than anything, touch people emotionally. And I think people have said that they feel really satisfied at the end of seeing the film. I think that's what it is hopefully it's firing on all cylinders, that you're getting the laughs, you're getting the adrenaline of the action, but also that you're being really affected emotionally.
Mm-hmm. You see, I see a movie and everything flows and it works, but when you're working on the film, and there's even a scene in the movie where Hero is kind of bumping his head.
Yeah.
You have one of those
We had so many of those
moments. You know animation. Yeah,
that scene kind of summed up the making of, that is the making of Big Hero 6, is that scene banging his head against the desk. But
yeah,
it's sort of our process, you know, we just keep at it and keep at it and keep at it until we feel like we have achieved what we set out to do.
Yeah, we work in a really iterative way. We make version after version of the movie, version after version of scenes, of moments, and we just keep banging our heads against the wall, trying to figure it out, trying to make it better, until it flows the way it needs to. It's the way that we approach it.
And this one in particular was, from a storytelling perspective, was difficult, you know, in that essentially we had two stories we were telling. We had this emotional story about this boy who loses his brother and a robot that becomes, you know, his healer, his surrogate big brother. We also had a superhero origin story we were trying to do too. And I remember very early on, I come into Chris's office, you know, even before he was on the movie, and just, you know, pulling my hair out because I couldn't.
I would hold him.
He would.
Comfort him.
They're there. It's okay. Like Baymax. He was my Baymax. you know, it just because it was very difficult to weave those two stories together, but eventually we finally cracked it.
Mm-hmm. Of course, people is already talking about an eventual sequel. Do you allow yourself, when you are working in the first movie, to even think about, let's set up something for the future or not?
Not really.
No,
we're not
really,
that smart.
Yeah, the last 3.5 years, we've invested everything that we have into this film, and people certainly have been asking about a sequel. And the nice thing about Disney Animation is that the ball is really in our court. Mm-hmm. No one's going to impose a sequel on us. We're only going to make one if Don decides that it's the right thing to do, and if we have a great story to tell. Then we'd pursue it, but we have no plans presently.
And also, you know, now would not be the time to even try and do that, because we're very, you know, we're at the end of our of this movie's journey, as far as, you know, it's almost released worldwide now. I think we have two more territories. It's still China and France, and then, you know, it's coming out on DVD and Blu-ray. So it's time to then go on a vacation and take a nice long break, be with our families a little bit, and just see where our heads are at. So that has to come first.
Awesome. I wish you luck at the Oscars, but you guys already won a lot of hearts and minds around the world. So
thank you.
Congratulations.